We have one naughty boy over here who is guarding not only his treat, but also his brother's treat. You're not allowed to guard treats, and you're definitely not allowed to steal your brother's as well. Should we give one back to Dickie? Okay, I was able to retrieve it. Look, this is yours. This one's yours. I have to be careful because he can get a bit snarly if you try and steal both of his treats. Dickie's looking on. There you go, my Tintin. And this little boy's been naughty because not only did he do a little wee-wee on Mummy and Daddy's new boot rack, but when Mummy was distracted by a builder at the door, this little boy decided to run all the way upstairs, both up two flights of stairs, all the way into the furthest room in the house, the attic bedroom. The only reason that I knew that he was up there was because I heard this little trot, trot, trot on wooden floorboards. You're both very bad, but I adore you. Okay, my camera balancing is not going very well this morning, so I'm gonna sit on the floor to do a little unboxing with you. Good morning, by the way. I hope you're all doing well. It's a Friday morning as I'm filming this. We have a lot of building activity, gardening activity, all kinds of activity going on everywhere, but this room feels like a bit of a haven. I really wish I'd put some dry shampoo in and made an effort with my hair, but never mind. So, this feels like a very formal start to the vlog, but I needed to be hands-free because I have just received my delivery from Holland Cooper, and I wanted to share this unboxing experience with you because the actual unboxing is so part of the overall experience. It is just so beautifully packaged. So within the box, I mean, look how gorgeous that looks. And inside the hat box, I would personally like to thank you for shopping at Holland Cooper. I hope you love your purchase. Best wishes, Jade Holland Cooper. I think that is so, so lovely. This is not sponsored in any way, but Holland Cooper very kindly sent these pieces to me, for which I am very, very grateful. So I thought I would share them with you because actually I had a couple of messages on Instagram since I posted this picture asking for a Holland Cooper haul. So I hope that you guys are excited to see these pieces, which I cannot wait to wear over the next few weeks and months. The brand is really beautiful quality, gorgeously luxurious pieces made and designed here in the UK. Their wool is sourced up in Scotland, and as you'll see, just the most beautiful designs, whether you live in the city or the countryside. But I personally feel like if you want to nail that luxurious countryside chic, then this brand is just absolutely gorgeous. I have a few pieces from them that I wear over and over and over again because the quality is so fabulous. So as you know, I just love a hat. I love a wool fedora hat, keeps my head so nice and warm. I do get migraines quite easily, and sometimes you want something a little bit smarter than a bobble hat. So let's hide my bad hair day. Oh, I just love this. So I went for this forest green shade. This is a size small and it fits me absolutely perfectly. I reckon I could have gone for a medium as well, but actually I think it's good that this is small. See it pulling up my eyebrows then, because if a gust of wind comes along, it's not going to take this away. So it's this green wool, and then you've got this feather detail, perfect for outdoor pursuits at this time of year especially. And I said in, I think, my last vlog that I feel like all socializing this autumn winter is going to be outdoors, so I think we need to invest in some really good warm accessories. So yeah, this is the first piece, a little close up here. Absolutely gorgeous. Oh my god, Charlie's gonna be so happy. So they actually said, oh, would Charlie fancy a baker hat, and they have sent not one, not two, but three baker hats for Charlie. And I keep saying to him he needs to get a hat, because a hat that he actually likes wearing, because his head gets so cold when we go out on walks. So he's got like a houndstooth one here. This one is more of a chevron kind of herringbone pattern. And then this one is more of a classic kind of tartan style pattern, and they feel so gorgeous. Oh, it's just so lovely. Thank you for choosing Holland Cooper. We hope that you love wearing this as much as we have loved creating it for you. I just love all these little touches. Charlie is going to absolutely adore those. And then I have some gorgeously classic autumn pieces, which you guys are gonna love and I'm gonna want to wear all the time. First of all, this just perfect chunky Fair Isle knit, and it's got the signature Holland Cooper buttons on the sleeve here and also on the neckline, which gives it a really nice military feel. This jumper just makes me want to light a fire in the garden, toast some marshmallows, go to a firework display, that kind of thing. I just want to be doing cozy outdoor pursuits wearing this jumper. Really gorgeous, chunky roll neck. I'm gonna wear this later today, or at least definitely over the weekend. It's actually really weighty. It's quite a heavy jumper. So, so classic. That is just the most gorgeous piece, and it's so, so soft. And then this next piece, oh my goodness, I'm so excited for this. Oh, it is just the most perfect countryside attire gilet. I just love a good gilet, and they really don't come much more fabulous than this. My mum is gonna be so jealous. So you've got this gorgeous faux fur trim, and it is very, very good quality faux fur. Then you have got, I thought this was actually leather, but it's more just like a coated material. It's not leather. You've got the iconic buttons at the top here, little pocket detail, this trim, and then a really chunky gold zip. I'm not wearing it the best knit underneath because it's a v-neck, but we'll get the picture. Oh my goodness, this is just absolutely beautiful. It's so cozy. Oh my gosh, if I do up these buttons as well. Oh, oh my gosh, this is it. This is countryside Josie. Don't even remember Clapham City Josie anymore. Goodness me, I am just absolutely in love. So this, oh my gosh, this collar, this neckline is so, so comfortable. And I like that it's got this darker detail in here as well. So I'm not gonna, I'm hopefully not gonna get any makeup on here. This tartan style fabric is just absolutely gorgeous. And these little pockets, I could probably unpick that at the moment. It's just sewn shut, but actually I probably won't, because to be honest, I will wear a crossbody bag when I'm out and about wearing this, because I wouldn't want to ruin the shape, the silhouette of the gilet. But oh my gosh, I absolutely love this so, so much. It would look gorgeous with the Holland Cooper knit underneath as well. This style gilet, a hat like this, this is a very bougie dog walking outfit, or just any kind of occasion in the countryside. If I go to any masterclasses at Daylesford, a nice day at Soho Farmhouse, I feel like this is my new countryside style, and I absolutely love it. I've just come upstairs and I wanted to show you some new jewellery that I have just received and straight away just put on, because like a child, as soon as I get something new, I want to play with it, I want to wear it. And this lovely delivery, gosh, I've got something in my eye. This lovely delivery has just come from Astrid and Miu, and this necklace I have just popped on straight away. I feel like I'm wearing the perfect cardigan to showcase this. If I flip you around, you might be able to see it a little bit better. It's got quite a chunky, almost like rounded chain. It's quite different to any other chains that I have got, and it is so, so lovely. This is quite a like organic shaped pendant, and I'm just loving this chunky yellow gold. I can't believe how much my jewelry taste has changed in the last like 18 months. I would never have worn anything that wasn't rose gold this time, like even maybe this time a year ago, but now I just love yellow gold. I've got my bracelet on. These earrings are also new, just now from Astrid and Miu. They're quite like a chunky hoop, and it takes a certain kind of very elegant hoop for me to wear it, especially when I've got my hair up, because I feel like I can look a little bit, I don't know what the word would be, not myself with certain hoops. And then I'm gonna hold the camera with my left hand, which is very not strong. And then I've also just popped on this beautiful new bracelet, which is also a rounded linked chain, and you've got this T-bar, T-shaped clasp closure. I just did that very awkward positioning to show you the bracelet, but this is the new bracelet. As you can see, it has got this T-bar clasp and the round loop style chain. I think that's my DHL delivery guy just arriving, so I just want to very quickly show you this little tray which I have set up on my dressing table. I wanted to keep it really neat on here, other than a coffee cup. This is all I would like to live on my dressing table. I have got a Tom Ford lipstick and my current perfume, which is the Tom Ford Soleil Neige. This is so beautiful, perfect for this time of year. Very elegant fragrance. By Terry lip balm, that's the body oil, that's the same fragrance. A Nice Cream London Silk hair bubble, diffuser in the rose oud scent from Candalia, and a Monica Vinader candle on this tray, which was very kindly sent by the Clé de Peau team. And there's the door. I'm back again. Yes, it was DHL, but mostly stuff for Charlie. I keep getting whiffs of myself in the nicest way possible. I have to give a huge, huge shout out to this. And I actually just Googled what was in this downstairs, and their description was really lovely. They said it was the fragrance, and it's from the Tom Ford Private Blend. They describe the fragrance as mirroring that beautiful winter light, which I would say it definitely does. Fresh, glacier-like fragrance. It's got carrot seed, bergamot, and vanilla in there. And it is a very premium fragrance, but I feel like with perfumes, you do get what you pay for. I spritzed this hours ago this morning, and I still, not gonna lie, I smell absolutely amazing. I feel like it kind of goes with what I'm wearing today, with a fluffy white knit. It is, yeah, absolutely gorgeous. Perfect for a sunny winter's day. I know we're not quite there yet, but a sunny autumnal day is what we have. Another gorgeous view from the window. The garden is looking a lot neater. My brother is actually here and he's helping us with a little bit of gardening. He's doing some leaf raking and he's tidied the pond, so you can see his piles of leaves everywhere. Over there, behind the fly. And down there, he's a busy bee. A very colourful and healthy lunch. Charlie went to Quince and Clover on his way back from the farmhouse and picked up some salads. Yummy. So later on this afternoon, Charlie's parents are coming over, so I thought I would whip up a banana bread. I feel like I am just using the Thermomix so much lately. I think I've used this every single day for the last 3 weeks straight, whether it's a soup or a risotto or my morning smoothie or a banana bread. So I am just going to follow the banana, maple and pecan Thermomix recipe. It takes about 10 minutes of my time, obviously a bit longer than that in the oven. So I'm gonna whiz this up and hopefully it'll be baking and fresh out the oven when they arrive. Okay, no word of a lie, I think I may have just set the Guinness World Record for the fastest ever banana bread preparation. I can see on my camera that took me a grand total of 7 minutes. 7 minutes from raw ingredients to ready-to-bake banana bread. That is what I love so much about the Thermomix. Honestly, I should be a Thermomix ambassador. Love it so much. So this is gonna go in the Arga now until it is ready. As you just saw, I literally emptied out my pecan jar, so I'm gonna have to add those to the shopping list. But I thought I would just sprinkle the crumbs that were all in the bottom of here on the top and make it into a nice little nutty top. I've done it quite messily, but I have now got a few extra minutes before Charlie's parents arrive to lick this bowl clean, get the ingredients away, do the washing up, and we are in control of the situation. Okay, let's bake. Goodness me, that low autumnal sunshine. I've already had some messages saying that I'm overusing the word autumnal. Well, I'm sorry, it's just gonna get worse for the next few weeks. I just wanted to show you, you may have seen in the background of the clip, the speed time lapse, but we have just received our new kitchen chairs and Charlie has absolutely smashed it with these. They look as though they are built to perfectly match our kitchen table. The kitchen table was kind of built with a kitchen. It is the same lime washed oak as the cabinets, and we previously just had our stopgap white chairs, but look at that. That could not be a better match. They literally look as though they were made by the same carpenter. They've got this crisscross design at the back, very similar to our dining room chairs, and this cream cushion at the base to make them nice and comfy. Not sure how practical cream is, but I'm sure it'll be fine. I might actually spray it with some liquid proof, but how great do they look? I'll have to ask Charlie when he comes down what website he bought them from, but I am very, very pleased with those. Let's have a look from a different angle. Yes, absolutely gorgeous. Here we have some freshly ironed face masks. Goodness me, did you ever think that ironing your silk face masks would be something you'd be adding to your chores list? And I've actually received a few different face masks in PR packages lately, so I thought I would just do a little face mask haul because we all need them these days, so I thought I would show you some of my favourites. I think that cotton ones can actually sometimes be the most practical. This one from LK Bennett I think is really lovely with the polka dot. It's nice to have a few different styles and colours to match your outfit. If you just love the feel of silk, then my favourite silk eye mask brand, Slip, they now do face masks as well. I have this beautiful light pink one and it is just the most gorgeous, gorgeous shade. I've not used this one yet. Oh, there's some washing instructions. 30 degrees, wash with your delicates. I mean, I probably wouldn't actually wash with my delicates because I'm not sure that they should be combined, but that is absolutely beautiful. I also have three here from Senrev. Senrev that I have my gorgeous cashmere cardigan from and my beautiful bags. They've got some in the folded pleated design and some in this face shape design. I really love the pattern of this. I think it's great for my autumnal outfits. And they also sent this leather kind of carrier. Haven't figured out how to attach it yet, but you basically clip this onto your face mask and then you just have this very chic leather, almost necklace style design for when you don't want to be wearing them. So if you want to let it hang around your neck or whatever in between your times when you need to wear a face mask. Got loads of filters. I only really wear filters on my days when I'm going into London. I feel like if I'm just popping into a cafe around here, I'm just super quick, have it on for a grand total of 2 minutes while I grab my bread or whatever. So it's not really worth using a filter. I mean, if it was busy in there, then I would, of course, but yeah. This was very kindly sent to me. My goodness, again, I just would never have thought that face masks would be something I'd be getting in PR, but this came from a lovely brand called Holistic Silk. As you can imagine, just the most beautiful quality silk. Very comfortable straps. These almost remind me of the kind of my silk slip hair bobbles, and a really beautiful deep purple shade, perfect for this season. Oh, I stupidly washed it with the wire and that was a bit silly. I saw this one advertised to me on Instagram. I can't remember the name of the brand. I think it's literally just called like silk face masks. This one was, where's this one from? Oh, that's gonna really annoy me. Was it Piglet or Bedfolk? Maybe it was Bedfolk. I'm sure it came with one of my bed linen sets. I actually leave this one in the car for emergencies and in case I've forgotten. And then this one is from The Vampire's Wife. It was a very kind gift from the girls at Elizabeth Arden. This one is really a special one because it's so beautiful, but I have to say I can't wear it for long periods of time because these little bits really tickle my eyelashes. So it's kind of a bougie one for photos and things like that and good for short periods of time. So yes, how crazy is that? I think I'm gonna leave these two in the car. And then in my belt drawer, I have got a face mask section. These ones I purchased from Mask by Amber. She dropped me a message on Instagram and I went on her site and picked some up. This one was It's from Casetify. Again, I think I might put that in the car. That's another good last minute one, or in my dog walking bag in case we go into a pub or anything. And then this was one of my first fancy ones. This is from Needle and Thread. So I'm gonna pop all of these in my little mask section for as and when I need them. So this is looking and smelling amazing. I always set a halfway alarm, so it's been in the Argo for 25 minutes, and then cover it in foil, and this will stop the pecans and the top of the banana bread getting too burnt or crispy, and yet still let the insides cook. So that's a little sneaky tip. So it's gonna go in for another, we've had 25 minutes. Alexa, set an alarm for 20 minutes. Charlie's parents have just arrived. We're quickly putting the patio back. It has finished being grouted. Look at that sky. Beautiful sunshine over there and black storm clouds over there. The patio looks amazing. Newly grouted. The lawns are freshly mown. This area is just looking so neat and tidy. We've got a lot of plant pots to put back, but it just looks epic. Looks so, so good. We have de-weeded the duck pond as well. That's looking much better. But this is an absolute triumph. Come on! Your granny and granddad have just got here, little bunny. Come on, let's go and see. Let's go and see. Come on. Come on! Just realised the patio is almost identical to our kitchen floor. Come on! Let's go and see. Where's your brother? God, you're so stubborn. Come on. Little terror. Come on. Who is it? Who's just arrived at Diggy's house? I reckon one more minute and this would have been absolutely singed. I always forget how hot the Argo is, but it's only really the tips of the pecan nuts, which is slightly burnt, but oh my goodness, this smells incredible.
So yeah, Dad bought John Josie some flowers,
what he came home with when I told him roses. Oh, she's
Charlie.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Do you know what I thought I'd done, right? Only on one test. But what that meant was...
Well, the banana bread was a great success. It had rave reviews from Charlie's mum and dad, and even Charlie had a slice, and I have to say, it was very, very good. So despite the speediness, it was